that backdrop, this tale of the tape is brought to you by VeChain, the official blockchain of UFC. Marlon Chito Vera is 30. Pedro Munhoz still among the elite at 36. Marlon Vera taller by a couple of inches, more pronounced in reach, where his edge is 5.5 inches. All right, now for the official introductions. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are... TD Garden in Boston, Massachusetts! For UFC 292, Sterling versus O'Malley, presented by Crypto.com, the world's leading cryptocurrency platform. And now, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC Bantamweight Division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist holding a professional record, 20 wins, 7 losses, 2 no contests. He stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of São Paulo, Brazil, presenting the number 10 ranked UFC bantamweight contender in the world, Pedro the Young Punisher. And now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist holding a professional record, 20 wins, 8 losses, 1 draw. He stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 136 pounds, fighting out of Chile, Manabe, Ecuador, presenting the number 6 ranked UFC bantamweight contender in the world, Marlon Chito. When the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
It is remarkable how loud it is when you take the cans off for a second.
Yeah. Woo. People are excited in here, man.
I love this sound.
Well, Joe, of course, headlined here as a comic, sold this place to the nines. I know that was very special for you back in the day. Tonight, Marlon Vera and Pedro Munhoz charged with kicking off the pay-per-view. Cheeto's in green, Munhoz is in black. Vera talked a lot in our fighter meeting about a lot of 5-round fights, 3 straight main events. This is 3 rounds, and instead of getting his reads and taking his time, he said he's going to get right after it. We shall see.
Well, he's traditionally a slow starter. And so he finds himself trying to work his way back in the fight, so it would benefit him to try to get going a little earlier. Oh!
Gotta be careful with that.
Yeah. Munhoz in the low leg kicks, man. He's a great leg kicker. He's got to keep setting it up with his hands up.
Nice jab by Vera early.
Those American top team guys, they adopted that very early. Mm-hmm. And Pedro was one of the first. So much volume from Pedro. And again, you can't forget about the man's ground game. He's a legit world champion Brazilian jiu-jitsu artist. And on the ground, he's phenomenal.
That was a beautiful jab there by Vera.
Marlon has so much confidence in his knockout power. They exchange front kicks to the body. Marlon's got to pick up the pace. Pedro is starting to really accelerate and put a lot of volume on him. And at least in the judge's eyes, this is going to be a deficit that he has to overcome.
Munhoz really preserved his championship aspirations with that win over Chris Gutierrez back in April.
That was a huge win. Gutierrez is extremely talented. And Munhoz put tremendous pressure on him in that fight. There's that jab from Chito. And he throws that jab square. It's very interesting how he stands. He stands with his shoulders almost totally square. And he throws things from both sides from there.
Well, it's because it's a power jab.
Yeah.
Cheeto's not touching you with a jab. And no, neither is Munhoz. Yeah. Those are power jabs with the intent to hurt you.
Anderson Franca, Conan Silvera, Ivan de Oliveira, chief in the American top team corner of Pedro Munhoz tonight. Shot for Munhoz. Chito stays upright.
boy, they're beating each other's legs up early. You got to wonder after you see a fight like that Brad Tavares, Chris Weidman fight, if everybody starts thinking, man, leg kicks. 1-2 by Cheeto.
Oh, now a knee.
Knee didn't quite connect. Caught the forearm.
This is Pedro's Emoto. He beats up the legs. He's very active. He always shows up in phenomenal shape. Never gets tired. And is just always so game to fight.
And as he said during the walk-in, he's in this stage of his career now that he can just fight. He can just get out there and flow. He has so much experience and so much belief in himself that he just kind of lets things happen. Good left hand from the southpaw stance. He switched it up. Oh, another one. Right hand from the orthodox. Right now, the volume is favoring Pedro Munhoz.
They're landing at about the same rate. Pedro's just throwing a lot more. But again, that's Pedro recognizing and knowing that Cheeto's a very slow starter. Cheeto always builds in the fight, but what he has to recognize is he does not have five rounds to work his way back into this fight.
And Munhoz does not slow down.
No.
This is his pace for five rounds. It would be his pace for 10 rounds. Good jab by Cheeto.
Nice short hook to the body by Vera. ...30 seconds to go in the round as Munhoz connects again. Very interesting times in the UFC's bantamweight division. Cheeto set to showcase tonight.
Sorry. I was just going to say, Cheeto checked that one. A lot of pressure by Munhoz.
All right, this corner cam is brought to you by Prime Hydration, the fastest growing beverage in history with only 25 calories, zero added sugar, BCAAs, and electrolytes, now available at Walmart.
I'm gonna put some water in for you. Just give me some breathing. Let's figure out this breathing. Okay, listen. Listen, just rest as much as you want. Now, listen, we need to move more. We need to move our head a little more, okay? We need to start using the... He's lowering his head a lot. You need to use the uppercut a little more.
Here's a nice jab from Marlon. Another beautiful jab by Cheeto. And you see the marks on Munhoz's nose from that. There's a low kick by Pedro and another one right afterwards.
The past, present, and future of combat sports lives on UFC Fight Pass. Watch 30 years of combat sports history with the world's largest combat sports library, plus over 25 exclusive combat sports organizations from around the globe with live events every weekend. Download the UFC app now. All right, here we go. Round two. Conan Silvera looking for a little bit more defensive movement and responsibility from Munhoz.
I'd like to see Pedro level change. He did one time in the first round. He needs to break the rhythm of Vera. Vera's far too comfortable right now, standing in front of him, popping him with jabs. This is his type of fight.
Marlon is throwing a very unusual kick. He's thrown it many times. It's a crescent kick, an inside crescent kick, where he's picking up that front leg, and he's coming with the outside of his foot to the side of the face. It hasn't landed yet, but it's very unusual.
I'm looking at some of these tweets. A lot of people scored the first round for Munhoz. I thought it was really close.
I would agree.
I wouldn't be confident and scored it for either of these guys.
I think the volume favored Munoz. Mm-hmm.
It did. But Chito landed a lot of great strikes in that round also. Pedro was so active. But I mean, when they land 24 to 22 shots.
And there's that Vera jab again. It has led the dance tonight. Munoz to that lead leg. Good left hand by Munoz, coming up on 3 minutes to go in the round.
Marlon tends to rely on the big shot because it's served him so well. The knockout of Dominic Cruz, the knockout of Frankie Edgar. He has that kind of knockout power.
The Equalizer 3, starring Denzel Washington, witness the final chapter exclusively in movie theaters September 1st.
That's a nice shot there by Munoz.
Yeah, right. Good right hand again.
Another one.
Munoz.
But for the most part, these guys are really rolling with shots. They're not taking anything clean. Both of them are doing a good job defensively of moving out of the way to the punches. The jab has been the most effective strike for both guys.
Marlon started to turn up the heat a little bit. See, he put a little bit more pop on his shots.
But like that, Pedro blocked both of those.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing landed.
And then immediately fires a three-piece back, right? Nice right hand from Munoz. Body shot is there for Vera. Coach Dean Thomas, what do you got, kid?
You know, the one thing that I like that Pedro Munoz is doing is he's always matching the stance of Chito Vera. So whatever stance Chito Vera stands in, Pedro's going to match that, so he always has access to that calf kick.
Yeah, you're right, Dean. Chito goes orthodox. Pedro follows him. Good read, good pickup, Dean. Look at that.
Yep, right away.
He just did it, yep.
Yep.
Looked like there was a right hand in there from Chito that bothered Munoz. Now beautiful jab.
Chito's jab has landed consistently.
That jab has so much sting on it. There it is again. And Pedro returns.
Under a minute here to decide round two of a possible three.
These guys are boxing.
Yes. Amazing.
They're boxing with 4 ounce gloves. They throw the leg kicks, but they're so close to each other. Right in punching range.
Some really good moments here.
Ooh, good left and then a right behind it by Munoz.
Both of these guys landing quite a bit late in round two. Nice counter shot from Vera. Well, Cheeto's had a penchant for having some outstanding third rounds and getting stronger as the fight goes on. Third and final round coming up.
There you go, you got some energy. All right, I know this is where you really come out, and we've been winning this fight, so good. All right, let's still put it on in this round. Let's push him back and bust his whole face up. I'll tell you, I love that jab, bud. It's beautiful, you're touching him. All right, you're sinking that left hook to the body too a little bit. But again, go ahead. You did it one time. You did punch your way in, you know, to give yourself a second go. Let's see if we can get a second go, all right? Let's push this guy back. If you get in some type of clinch,
I need you to give me everything that you got, okay? You or your condition and you're prepared for this. Are you listening to me? Listen, this fight is really tight. We need to continue to pressure him. He's trying to stall you, okay? Every time you pressure him, just continue things. Continue fainting. Continue pressuring him. Go and take him against the cage. It combos all the time. It combos all the time.
All right, round three is brought to you by The Equalizer 3, starring Denzel Washington. Witness the final chapter exclusively in movie theaters September 1st. You may have caught the numbers there. Pretty significant advantage in that significant strike column for Pedro Munoz in that second round. Landed 46 of them.
Right.
Third and final round, high stakes at 135.
Second round was not as close as the first. But I mean, Vera's landing the jab pretty consistently. But as Joe said in round one, he is just not matching the effort of Pedro Munhoz.
Yeah, you heard Jason Perillo talk about the energy of Chito. He liked it late round two.
He needs more volume in this round. This is really the round. I mean, who knows who won those first two rounds? Mm-hmm. The second round, it seemed like the volume favored Munhoz, but Chito does land some hard shots, and that jab is punishing. But Munhoz is such a veteran, every time Chito lands, Munhoz comes back.
Good work with the hands by Vera
right there.
Yep, and there it is again.
Yeah, I mean, he's so consistent with that, that it makes it very difficult to figure out who's winning these exchanges.
And even when Pedro's not landing, he just throws. So even if he's hitting you on the gloves, he's still hitting you.
Oh, stung him with that.
Wow.
Stung him with that.
That jab put him in the chair a little bit.
Another one. Those are real. Those are some solid jabs.
Seems like overall the more damaging strikes have been landed by Vera.
I'd like to see Vera turn it up now. I think Munhoz got stung. He's hurt.
He's hurt bad.
Body head forced a shot from Munhoz. And then he fired upstairs.
His face is getting busted up with that jab again.
And that's what a jab does, right? It might not show early, but it just breaks you down. And as you get deeper into the fight, keep getting hit with that jab, all of a sudden it's taking an effect on you.
And there it is again. Oh, 1-2. Oh, and another right hand by Vera. He is busting up Pedro Munhoz's face. He hits it again.
Strong start to the round for Chito Vera. Pedro Munhoz has never been finished as an MMA pro.
Chito's getting the better of these exchanges now. This third round so far is his. Nice left shot to the body.
Nice body shot.
Chito Vera coming on strong in the latter rounds.
Chito has so much endurance. I mean, the man is a tireless worker, runs every day, miles and miles, for this specific reason.
Joey says he does 15-mile runs.
Yeah.
15 miles in one time. That's crazy.
Look at that jab. But look how in shape he is because of that. The man has incredible cardio. And that jab is finding a home on Pedro Munhoz's face.
It's a matter of when he lets the right hand go behind it. Because right now, Pedro's not picking up on the jab anymore. So there it is. He's got to start to fire it. Behind the jab, though, not off a slap hook. Because he hasn't hit him with a slap hook. If he hits him with the jab, he's got to let the right hand go right behind that jab. He might be able to hurt Pedro.
Beautiful left hand.
Munhoz eats it and returns, but that was one of the more significant strikes of the fight on either side.
And this jab is money. Again, look at that. It's the story of the jab.
And even though Munhoz landed in counter, Vera doesn't even react to that power at all.
And he was moving away from it. It took a lot of the sting off of it. Whereas Munhoz is moving forward as Marlon's popping him. Oh, and he goes high.
Nothing resembling visible damage on Vera, really. Nice counter left from him there.
But he is really catching Pedro with that jab. There it is again and again.
And how about that? Unofficial, but Chito has pulled ahead on the numbers. Round one to this point, the closest of the three. Anybody's fight down the stretch. Nice stick and move by Munhoz.
Two good kicks to the body.
No takedown attempts from Pedro. One in the first round, and that was it. But we're, you know, the guy's such a veteran. He's been in there with so many high-level fighters that he doesn't feel like there's anywhere that he's lacking. So striking Chito. Just another fight.
Counter right is there for Munhoz. Spinning attack from Vera.
Close fight.
Great fight Pedro Munhoz, Marlon Chito Vera go the distance as many fans expected. In a fight with huge implications in the men's 135-pound division. Tonight's fight replays are brought to you by Sweet Sweat, an official partner of the UFC.
Look at that jab. I mean, a thing of beauty. Pops him with that jab.
Never long without a fight. UFC middleweight champion Israel Adesanya looking to defend his UFC title not far from home against the upset-minded American slash volume striker Sean Strickland. We're back in Sydney for the first time in 6 years. It's UFC 293. Saturday, September 9th. It's available on ESPN Plus pay-per-view in the U.S. UFC.com/PPV everywhere else. Marlon Chito Vera.
Here we go.
And Pedro Munhoz awaiting the scorecards. Bruce Buffer has them.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. The judges score the contest 30-27. 30-27 and 29-28 for the winner by unanimous decision, Marlon Chito Vera.
All right, so Marlon Chito Vera gets it done. 30-27, a little bit interesting given that second round. The damage seems to reign supreme in 2023, and Marlon Chito Vera is the winner tonight.
Yeah, very interesting that second round. I would have given that round to Munhoz, but it was close. And look at the face of Marlon Chito Vera. Shows no...
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.